Hey everybody, what's up? So today's video, kind of wanted to show you guys Ancient Apparition versus Shadow Fiend because some people actually don't know how to play this matchup very well. So EOF, aka, what the hell name does he go by these days? Harrod Hig on Team Liquid and Delphic on NA Dota. He decided to submit this because he thought it was cool. So basically the whole goal of this lane is to get your Ice Blast. But if you're wondering how to beat a middle like Shadow Fiend, this is one of those things where you just cast one spell and you kind of just win. It's kind of similar to how Queen of Pain works when you're up against certain mid heroes. So you see him activating the Chilling Touch for the bonus. He's just using that to last hit. Not too much there. That's kind of standard. So at level 2 you get the cold feet and you can pretty much dominate this, but I just wanted you guys to kind of see it. So not too many gameplay changes happened in the patch other than techies coming in. Otherwise I think the true 6.82 is supposed to happen hopefully soon, so you get to see how cold feet works. There you go, you can right click him to death. Half HP, he gets scared off the lane and you're free to farm it. We're gonna watch this a little bit more, just so we can see how the Shadow Fiend tries to rebound from this. So he's probably going to skittle up in, oh he did, in Chilling Touch. That's just for more right click, but there is a drawback, so you do lose a bit of the attack speed. So you can see 1-1 compared to 8-7 on this Ancient Apparition. So some people think that Ancient Apparition should always play support. You could, and it's okay. So you see the man up with the cold feet. Oh, this Shadow Fiend is almost dead. Yeah, you can't go in there too low, and tower's just gonna focus you. But you can kind of see the power of Ancient Apparition middle. This used to be an older thing in competitive play. I think Bulba is the one who kind of did this the most out of everyone. So what I was saying about the Queen of Pain thing, you kind of cast your Shadow Strike and you proceed to right click, and then suddenly it's a free lane for at least a couple minutes, which gets you a lot of farm. So we're checking back on the Shadow Fiend. He's 3-1 with the Wraith Band, and we've got 11-8 on your Ancient Apparition. The Ancient Apparition player plays somewhat competitively. He was supposed to be on the started from the bottom team, but obviously, with North American Dota, you have a lot of boy band inner turmoil, so they break up, form again, and that's how the story's written. So 15-9, Shadow Fiend 7-1, so he's picked, I guess, a little bit. He's still getting blown out in CS, but, you know, I mean, it was a kind of a instant win mid spell. As far as other matchups, you could try to scare other heroes off with it, but a lot of them are pretty good at coming back. Shadow Fiend's one of those heroes where he's pretty much paper in the beginning, and then he gets stronger as time flies. But if you outdo him in the lane, then he's fucked for the rest of the game. As for other mid heroes where you have one instant win spell, kind of, you definitely have Queen of Pain, and she is the first one, I think, out of all of them to have that kind of thing happen. But we're going to end this here. I just wanted to show you guys Ancient Apparition mid. If you wanted to try it yourself, you can. But most likely, you may want to just try to play support with him. I know this particular player, Harrod Hig, is or EOF in this case, he is experimenting with the off-laning style. And so far it's going okay, but I'd have to get a real replay for it. And until he gives me a good one, there's no footage on that yet. So thank you guys for watching. It's been real. I'll see you guys later.